How does a sheet of metal become a SkyTrain car? This is how the newest addition to our fleet, the Mark V, comes to life. Like building a computer, parts are made separately, then assembled into cars, and finally into full trains. It all happens at this plant in La Pocatière, Quebec, a rail car factory with decades of experience building trains since 1971. Because the Mark V is so large, it doesn't move down an assembly line. Instead, the car stays in place while teams and equipment work around it. First comes the car frame. Cable harnesses are added, and prefabricated steel doors, sidewalls, and roof panels are primed, painted, and polished to perfection. The glue for the windows is placed by robots for pinpoint accuracy, then skilled workers install the windows by hand for the perfect fit. Brackets hold the roof and sidewalls in place, while a hydraulic bolting gun runs along a track to fasten everything together. The car is lifted, so crews can work above and below at once. Inside, temporary lights guide technicians, and bit by bit, it starts to look like a real train. The final big piece, the truck. It's the heavy base that carries the wheels, axles, and motor. With it installed, the car finally has the backbone it needs to run like a true SkyTrain. But building is only the beginning. Each car is shipped to Kingston, Ontario, where it faces three rounds of rigorous testing, simulating conditions found in Metro Vancouver. Static testing checks components, software, safety, and communication systems. Dynamic testing covers braking, propulsion, elevation changes, switches, and station stops in a fully autonomous environment. Finally, endurance testing runs the train for weeks to prove reliability for the real world. Before leaving Kingston, every detail is inspected. All conditions have to be met, all systems verified, and every corner checked. Only once everything is flawless is the train signed off on.
We went underneath the train in the pit to inspect everything, all the components underneath the train, the brakes and all the other components. And then we went inside the train to inspect the HVAC units, to inspect the seats, inspect the flooring, complete in-depth inspection of the train to flag anything that can be corrected at Kingston site before it's getting shipped to Vancouver.
So we check for any rattle that comes from the wedge screens. And if it's rattling, they recorrect it and tied it up according to the standard. We check for the rattle on any of these stanchions as well. If anything, any nuts or anything is loose, we check the flooring for any of any corners. If there's any spacing where water can seep in.
Some of the seats are very close to the main structure, and it's a pinch point where you can put your fingers in at one of the spots. We put a bracing at the back so that if the seat is pushed back, there's enough space and there is no pinch point there. Imagine you're buying a brand new car from a showroom. You inspect the whole car as your own because you're owning it. Same thing BCRTC employees are doing for these SkyTrains. I inspected every single small detail of this train like my own car.
From there, each car is craned onto a flatbed and hauled across Canada to SkyTrain's Operations and Maintenance Center 2 in Burnaby, BC. Here, it goes through another full round of static, dynamic, and endurance testing before entering service. From a sheet of steel to a fully tested train, the Mark V is built with precision, tested with care, and made ready to serve Metro Vancouver for decades to come.